हेलो चिल्ड्रेन, वेलकम बैक टू आर नेक्स्ट इंग्लिश क्लास एंड दिस इज़ योर नूपुर मैम स्पीकिंग। सो आई होप यू रिमेंबर द लास्ट चैप्टर बट आई वॉज टीचिंग। इट वॉज अ द स्टोरी ऑफ अली बाबा एंड 40 थीप्स। इट इज़ अ पार्ट 3 फ्रॉम अरेबियन नाइट्स एंड देयर आई हैव डिस्कस्ड द स्टोरी विद द लाइंस। आई होप यू हैव रीड एंड यू हैव अंडरस्टूड। सो I have completed till here. I hope you remember the robbers. They were finding who was the main, who was the person who knows each and everything, the secret of robbers, and they are frightened about it, and they made a trick to solve this problem to get that person. And after that, what happened? I hope you remember. In the last such paragraphs, I hope you remember these all. Okay, so after that, what happened? Let the false guide be put to death, on which the robber was quickly slain. Till here it was done. So I will continue after that. In spite of this, however, another came forward and offered to play the spy. He thought that if he marked the door with red chalk in a place not easily to be seen, all would be well. But Morgiana's quick eyes again discovered the mark. And when the robbers came, they found so many doors with red marks that they were no farther on than before. So you can understand now they are puzzled. Each and every time they are making the some mark, and each and every time same incident happens, right? So what the next? The captain at once ordered a second offender to be put to death, and he himself set out to discover the house with the help of Mustafa. I hope you remember Mustafa was a shoemaker, right? When he had walked up and down in front of it long enough to fix the appearance of it firmly in his memory, he went back to the camp. "Go into all the villages about," he said, "and buy 19 mules with 38 large leather jars, one full of oil and others empty." One full of oil and others are empty, right? So 2 days later, all was ready. The mules were loaded with 37 robbers in jars and one jar of oil. So what happened? Then after 2 days, what happened? The mules were loaded with 37 robbers in jars and one jar of oil. The captain led the way to the house. Ali Baba was sitting at the door at the time. And when the captain told him that he was on the way to the market with oil, he bade him welcome to his house. The jars were left in the garden, but the captain managed to whisper to the man in each, "When you hear me throw a few stones from my window, make haste to join me." Fortunately, what happened? Morgiana's lamp went out for lack of oil while she was busy at her work, and there was no oil in the house. So what happened? Fortunately, it was very fortunate. Morgiana's lamp on that moment went out for lack of oil while she was busy at her work, and there was no oil in the house. There seemed nothing for her to go to the next page. Page number 61, 62. Yes. So, there seemed nothing for her to go to the next page. I have written by pen here, you can see. Okay. So, there seemed nothing for her do but to go into the garden and take some oil out of the jars. Thus the robber's plot was found out. For instead of oil, Morgiana discovered a man in the first jar she opened. Is it time? He whispered. Not yet, she replied softly. For instead of oil, Morgana what discovered? Discovered a man in the first jar. She opened. Is it time? He whispered. Someone was whispering. Is it time? Not yet, she replied softly. She had to open several jars before discovering the oil. But as soon as she got it, she ran into the house, filled a kettle with oil, boiled it, and poured enough into every jar to stifle the robber within. Ali Baba was filled with amazement when he learned next morning that he had been entertaining the captain of the robbers. His gratitude to Morgiana knew no doubts, and he freed her from slavery with the promise of another reward letter. Meanwhile, the captain, who had escaped over the wall and returned to his cave, wished to have his revenge on Ali Baba. Accordingly, he started a silk merchant's business and was overjoyed to discover that Ali Baba's son lived opposite his shop. So he gave him bad presents, invited him to dinner, and did everything he could think of to make friends with him. So what happened? Accordingly, he started a silk merchant's business and was overjoyed to discover that Ali Baba's son lived opposite his shop. Okay, so he gave him presents, invited him to dinner. He did all whatever he could do to make friendship with him, right? Then Ali Baba asked his son's new friend to dine with him. This was the captain's chance. He was known at this time by the name of Kogia Hussein. At the time appointed, Ali Baba's son took him to his father's house. The faithful Morgiana was still there. Now it happened that as Kogia Hussein said he had made a vow never to touch salt, Ali Baba gave, go to the next page. Similarly, I have written by pen. Ali Baba gave orders to Morgiana to put on salt in the food. Her first glance at Kogia Hussein told Morgiana that he was a captain of the robbers. I must save my master, or this false merchant will slay him, she said to herself. Going to her room, she put on the dress of a dancer. She put on the dress of a dancer and fastened round her waist a handsome girdle from which hung a dagger. Then, having hid her face under a mask, she said to Abdullah, "Bring your drum, and we will amuse our master and his guest with music and dancing." Morgiana danced gracefully round and round the room to Abdullah's music, and then suddenly, seizing the dagger in her right hand, pretended to stab herself. But as she swept past Kogia Hussein, she buried it deep in the breast. So what happened? Morgiana danced gracefully round and round the room to Abdullah's music, and then suddenly seizing the dagger in her right hand. What pretending to stab herself? But she swept past Kogia Hussein. She buried it deep in his breast. So Ali Baba and his son were filled with horror. But Morgiana opened the disguised Kogia Hussein's clock, showed them a dagger, and told them who he really was. Ali Baba embraced her and gave her to his son in marriage. In due course, Ali Baba taught his son the secret of the cave, and with the riches they found, they were all able to live in comfort and even splendor. "Wonderful," said the Sultan, but the Enchanted Horse is another interesting story for which I don't have time. Could you narrate that? You will leave for another day. And here the part 3 is completed. Okay. And now I want to move to the question answer part. But before that, just read all the lines, all the paragraphs. If you have any problem to understand anywhere, or do you want to know any meaning? Do you have any problem anywhere in the meaning or in the line you can't understand? Definitely you can ask me in comment box, or you can ask me in WhatsApp class also. Okay, so thank you so much and bye-bye.